when working outdoors with corded power tools is, though it's nice to have a convenient outlet to use, but this particular outlet could kill me. Why? Because it's not GFCI protected. It's just a regular receptacle in there. And should the device that I'm using outside cause me to get grounded, then I have the potential of being electrocuted because this outlet won't do anything to stop that. In this video, we're going to replace the receptacle with a GFCI receptacle, and we're going to have to replace this cover. And it should be an easy installation. The one challenge to this project is this outlet has been trimmed in, so that could be a bit of a challenge, but we're going to find out once we start taking it apart. Things we're going to need for this project is a GFCI outlet, and this one comes with a very pretty decorative plate, which we'll repurpose for some other project. This one is self-testing, and it's not weatherized, but that's where the new metal box will come in. This will replace the double door box with a single flap, which can be locked, which I won't need to, but that will cover that. We should not need a box since one is already built in. But things we will need, possibly long nose pliers, diagonal wire cutters, maybe a pair of Kleiman tools, electrical tape, wire stripper, outlet tester. This will come in handy for two things. One, I'm not sure which circuit controls that outlet, so I will plug this in, flip the circuit breaker, and once these lights go out, then I'm pretty sure that that is the correct circuit breaker. Secondly, it allows me to test the outlet once everything is installed to verify that it's wired correctly. I will verify, of course, that there's no live wires in there with a tester, and then a Phillips and two flat blade screwdrivers will probably also come in handy. And I'm using a pouch to carry this out with. I may include a flashlight and maybe some gloves for my hands. With the outlet tester plugged in, I get two lights indicating it is properly wired. But now I will use those lights as an indicator of whether or not I've turned off the correct circuit. With the circuit breaker off, we see that there are no lights, so we know this receptacle has no power coming into it. All we do now is remove that screw, probably get a utility knife so we can free the wall plate. We pry off the outlet. We have a gasket that's in place. Gasket's removed. Now we work on taking out the actual receptacle. And it has a Phillips down here and a straight edge up here. So this has been altered from when it was originally installed back in 1968. And it looks like we're gonna have to do some more cutting around these ears, because this looks like maybe it's a silicone and somebody just got carried away. So we'll free that up. Normally I wouldn't advise sticking this inside because we're not 100% sure that there's no current in here. But this does have electrical tape. Okay, now we have wire, we have power coming in and going back out, neutral coming back in and going out, and some ground wire. Come in with the test probe. And we're going to make sure that everything inside this outlet is dead. So I have green, so there is no power going on here. And by the way, I did verify that this was working on a known energized unit so I can believe what it says. Here's the receptacle that we've removed. Usually you'll find a wire that's attached this way and you unscrew it and you make your disconnection. Sometimes there'll be push-in wires. I just wanted to show you what that's like. And those will be in like this and they don't come out unless you have the right tool, which in this case would be a Leatherman Squirt PS4, which just happens to drop in right in the slot that allows you to disconnect. And so the wire comes out. That's cool. Once you remove the wires from this, don't repurpose it. Just get a new one. They're not all that expensive. In this outlet, we have two pairs of wires, black and neutral, and black and neutral. Power is coming in on one of them, going out on the other one. Which one? I don't know yet. And that's important to know if you're using a GFCI because they want the line, the one that has power coming into it, hooked up to these two terminals. The brass gets the black and the white gets the neutral, but I'm not sure if it's this pair or this pair at this point. Then there's a piece of tape that goes across the other terminals, and that's for the load. So that's the load that's downstream. So the question is this the line? Is this the power coming in and is the load going down that way? Or is it the other way around? What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the power back on and then test the leads to see where we have power. We've energized the circuit, so we don't touch any of the wires. I do have my probe, and as you can see, I'm getting a red light here, not there, not over here, not anywhere else, just on this one. So this is the line side of the wire. This is where the power is coming in. So this will go connected to the top terminal. That's with the ground pin facing down. And then this one, which is called the load, and it's labeled, and it's taped off when you buy this, that'll get hooked up to this side. So now, before I do anything, I'm going to go back and turn off this circuit, and then test again. Circuit breaker is off. We come back, and we see that there is no power coming in here. And, you know, just a habit, I check everything anyway. So now, this will connect to the top terminals with the black going to the brassy looking terminal and then the white going to the white looking terminal, and then we will connect the black from this side to the brass on this side at the bottom and the white to the corresponding white side on the bottom. First thing I'll do, of course, is connect my ground, which connects at the bottom of this unit. So what I'll do is I'll connect ground, neutral, black, then do the bottom two. On this GFCI, there's no way to push the wires in, but you can insert them straight into the terminal and then they clamp down when you tighten, or you can wrap it around with a shepherd's hook. Since those are already straight, I'm just gonna push those in and clamp each one of them down, which will make it just a quicker installation. But you gotta make sure that these are on very tight. We've connected our ground, our neutral, and our power side. And this is all, these are the pair of wires that were coming from the side that was providing power, or what they're calling the line side. Now we go to the load side, which is where the electricity is going to go to, the outlets downstream, and those are going to get hooked up to corresponding terminals on the bottom side of this unit. But we'll have to remove this tape, of course. We've completed hooking up the line and the load wires to the GFCI. Now, note that when you insert your wire into this clamp-on connector, make sure that the wire goes all the way down to the bottom. It gets to the end of travel. If you need to, strip off some insulation, but make sure that you don't strip off so much insulation that there is wire exposed. The insulation should be butting up right up against the end. And now the fun part, getting all the wiring and the additional depth of this back into this box. One approach is to either wrap the wires in a circle or accordion them, where you can go up, down, or down, up, whatever, so that the wires compress back as you push them in. Good luck. The unit is installed. I didn't tighten these all the way down, only because I want to have just a little bit of flexibility when I go to put on the new cover, depending on how I have to adjust things. And we'll have to see if this cover actually even fits here. So that's our next step. Cut this out, see if it fits. This cover comes with a bunch of inserts. So for us, since I'm using this Decora, this is what's gonna fit over. Then these others I can toss. But the problem I see right now is the box is bigger than what was there originally, so I'm going to have to trim some of this material away for this to fit. So I'm going to try a oscillating saw should work for this. With a pencil, I traced where I need to remove some material. So we're coming up, just taking a little bit out of there, a little bit out of this corner. And to do that, we're going to use this multi-tool. This one's from Dremel. And of course, we're going to wear some hearing protection because it's quite loud. I prefer to cut too little than too much, so I may have to make slight adjustments as we go along. While making my cuts here, I noticed that there really was no place for this screw, which is the screw that's going to attach the cover plate to right here, to go back. So this screw is about an inch, and this would prevent it that. So what I did was I just loosened the outlet so that I could punch a little hole back there with the screwdriver, so that when we put this screw here, it'll have a place to travel back to secure the cover. The plastic template just snaps into place. And then we're gonna line it up, make sure everything fits. I may have to cut a little higher because this hinges, and you see when that hinges up, it takes up just a little bit of room. That hinge extends beyond the back plane here. So I may have to just cut a little bit. I'm gonna try not to, but so let's just install it and see what happens, okay? Okay, it actually worked out pretty well. The cover closes down, it opens up. You have access, nice access to both plugs, as opposed to the old one, which was the individual doors and they were cumbersome, they got in the way. I can secure it in case I don't want anybody tapping into my power, but I'm not that greedy. And cover is working just fine on the hinge without having to carve out any more material. So the last thing I'll do is, there's just a little bit of a gap here because you see how this goes further back. So I'm going to put a little bit of just silicone back there, just to seal that up, and probably also down at the bottom. So now all we are left to do is to energize the unit. And initially it probably won't work because you'll need to reset the GFCI. So let's plug this in and let's go and turn on the power. The power is back on. We look and nothing there. So let's hit the test mode. Let's hit the reset mode. Here. There we go, reset. Insert it back in. Nothing. Huh. We got a problem. You know, I should have tested the receptacle itself before I even installed it to make sure it was actually working. Because at this point, I know I have power coming down in here. So why isn't this unit triggering? We'll work on that and I'll let you know. Okay, so I've taken it apart. Let's see if you can spot the problem. Do you see it now? You see how there's a black wire here, but there's no black wire here? What happened to the black wire that was here? When I last left it, by the way, the circuit is off and it's been already tested. Look what happened. It broke off. So I guess when we bent it back, there must have been a weak spot there and it just cut off. So fortunately, no short circuit, no big deal. We'll go in there and just cut off some insulation and then reinsert and then try this again. When you reset, we get there are two yellow lights here. So we're good on that side. We're also good on this side. And you also get a green LED letting you know that the unit is operational. So now, should I plug, let's say, my hedge trimmer in here and the wire is frayed and I make contact with that live wire, this will kick off and save my life, as opposed to a circuit breaker, which won't necessarily detect that voltage drop because I'm being electrocuted. So this is the far safer way to go. And yes, some outdoor appliances do have their own Gfci boxes that will plug into that, and that's great, but a lot of them don't. And just because this is on the exterior, it should be Gfci. I believe it's code, like it is in the bathroom and in kitchens. Usually not a very hard installation. We ran into a couple of challenges with the box not quite fitting and one of the wires breaking off inside. But those things happen. This is what happens in real life. It's not a TV show. So if you found this interesting or useful, give us a thumbs up. Leave us a comment. Tell us what you thought about it. Is it something you would consider tackling if it's within your skill level and comfort level? Otherwise, hire an electrician. And as always, thank you ever so much for watching. Don't forget to join the subscription team. We really appreciate that. Thank you so much.